Why do scientists spend so much time and effort studying fruit flies? Is it because they're all bananas? No, flies are actually a lot like us. They have hearts, brains, muscles, and eyes. All organisms evolved from a common ancestor, and many biological parts haven't changed much. They are very similar in every organism. Because these parts work well and are so useful, they tend to stay the same. Think about a car. There have been lots of changes in design, but the wheels always stay the same shape. In broad strokes, humans divide their cells in the same way as simple cells like yeast. Every organism with a nucleus copies its DNA and separates the copies to two new cells using the same molecular machines. It's faster, easier, and cheaper to study a yeast cell than a human cell, so it makes sense to start studying cell divisions here. It turns out that many of the basic principles that we have discovered in yeast also apply to humans. So we say that yeast is a good model organism to study cell division. Indeed, the lessons we learned in yeast greatly accelerated our understanding of cell division and how it goes wrong in diseases like cancer. Over the past century, scientists have found ideal organisms to study each specific scientific problem. Fruit flies and roundworms have very similar neurons to humans and are able to learn and make complex decisions. These are great model organisms for neurobiology. Fish are a great model to study early development. In the beginning, fish look very similar to people. So you see, we think like a fly, we divide like yeast, and our bodies start out like fish. The underlying machinery of life is often very similar, even in seemingly very different organisms. But of course, the details matter too.